Hi everyone, Michael here. In this video, I'm going to be going over Joe Biden's new proposal to completely change the way the 1031 real estate exchange tax works. I'm going to go over what this means for us, what this means for the housing market, and what we can do to prepare. Because while this may seem great that they're taxing the rich, this may actually come to completely punish all people trying to buy a home right now. Okay, let's get into it. Okay, so you may see headlines saying Biden targets $41 billion tax break for rich real estate investors. Biden wants to cut back the tax break that allows real estate investors to continually keep upgrading to more and more expensive properties, and that way they don't have to pay capital gains tax. Because say, for example, you buy a piece of real estate for $500,000, it goes up to $1 million. Instead of selling that and having to pay capital gains tax on the $500,000 gain, you can do a 1031 exchange and then buy $1 million property or $2 million property without having to pay any tax at all. And so this may seem great. Yeah, let's tax the rich, let's punish the rich. Now, I'm not rich at all, so I'm not being biased here, but I'm just going to get into the facts, how this is going to affect us all. So what exactly is Biden proposing? What he's proposing is for rich real estate investors that make a capital gains of, say, for example, $500,000 or more and try to do a 1031 exchange so they don't have to pay tax on, for example, $500,000 to $1 million, he's going to make it so they can't do that. And then he's going to use that money to pay for things like free preschool for less wealthy Americans, which is good to try to help out the less fortunate, but this actually may come to bite them, and I'll get into that in a minute. And this proposal is expected to save $41 billion in tax revenue between 2020 and 2024. So who will these changes hit? Well, really, it's going to affect big real estate investors and small mom and pop retail investors as well, or even people that are planning to retire. Say, for example, you're a boomer or you're an elderly couple and you've got a couple of investment properties that you plan to sell once you reach retirement to fund your retirement. Say, for example, you've got $2 million in equity on two investment properties. You're going to have to pay nearly half of that in capital gains tax, and that could greatly affect your retirement plans. Now, they're saying this isn't going to affect small investors because it's only capped to capital gains over $500,000. But what this is going to lead to is big, large institutions, instead of doing a 1031 exchange and buying up big, huge properties, or for example, multifamily homes, they're now going to be targeting single family, smaller properties, and they're going to be targeting the affordable end of the market. So that way they can 1031 exchange individual properties where they make capital gains lower than $500,000. And what this means is all the affordable markets where first home buyers are going to try to get into and small mom and pop retail investors are going to try to get into, they're now going to have to compete with big, large institutions. And really, how would you feel knowing Wall Street is going to start buying up your whole suburb or your whole town? I definitely don't like it, and I definitely don't think you're going to like it. And also how this is going to affect you trying to buy your next home. This means you're going to have to compete with big, large institutions to try to secure that next home. And really, first home buyers and small mom and pop investors are not going to stand a chance. And really what this is going to do is make the affordable end of the housing market even more unaffordable. And what it's going to create is more financial risk, because all these big, huge hedge funds, they can take on huge risks and they can make asset bubbles and housing market bubbles, because then if they fail, they'll just go cry to the Fed and the Federal Reserve will come and bail them out, and that will just create more boom bust housing market cycles. Because during downturns, if you're an owner occupier and you love your home, if a housing market crash happens, you may be less likely to sell. Where if you're a big, huge institution and you got shareholders to answer to, if you know there's going to be a market crash, you have to be held responsible to those investors. So they're not going to have the emotional attachment to the home, and they'll just sell off all their investment properties like that. They'll cause a market crash, and they'll come back in when there's blood on the streets and after the bloodbath is finished, and they'll buy up all these homes for pennies on the dollar. And also, this is going to actually be very bad, because right now in the housing market, in this housing crisis, the thing that's contributing to the housing crisis is low supply. So if you're going to make it so people are taxed more and more when they sell, that means there's going to be less liquidity in the housing market and people are going to hold on for longer. And also what the rich can do to avoid taxes, which may be hard for smaller investors or may be hard for individual families that own a home, is what they can do is they can borrow against their assets. So instead of selling their property and paying, you know, 40 to 50% capital gains tax, whatever tax rate it's going to be, what they can do is then cash out refinance or refinance the property, and then they can only pay 3-4% interest, which is much lower than the tax rate, and they can pay that amount off over 30 years. So really, the rich will just find loopholes to get around this, and this will just end up punishing the small mum and pop retail investors. It'll end up destroying the middle class, and it'll destroy wealth building opportunities for those trying to use real estate to build wealth. But some people may think, like I've been saying, there's going to be a housing market crash. And what this could lead to, if say, for example, the mortgage forbearance comes to an end, eviction moratoriums come to an end, interest rates continue to rise, if bond yields continue to rise, and then these tax changes become announced, what this could cause is a flood of properties to come onto the market before these tax changes become implemented, and it could cause a flash crash in the housing market. And really, is this all part of the Great Reset playing out, where you will own nothing and you'll be happy? It seems like big financial institutions, the government, the central banks around the world, they're slowly buying up everything. And everything is becoming much, much harder for the middle class and the poor to acquire assets. And it's becoming harder and harder to build wealth. Because say, for example, if you're investing and you're getting a 7-8% return, well, if they're printing money at 20-30%, and if real inflation's at 7-8%, you're really just spinning your wheels and you're not getting anywhere. Meanwhile, the rich are coming up and buying up everything. So everyone, while these taxes on the rich may seem great, yes, give more money to people that need it, I do agree the rich do have to pay their fair share, but what I do think is they may start to go too far and start taxing the rich too much. And what you have to know is in every civilization and in every country, once all the rich start getting punished too much, and if you take all the intelligent, entrepreneurial, rich people out of society, and then it's only the welfare state left in that country, well, that's ultimately when the country comes collapsing down. And this is really why I think immigration doesn't work, because a lot of these third world countries, when they say come to the West, you know, it's so great, bring all these people into the Western countries like the US, Australia, Canada, etc. Well, really, it's the richer people that are leaving these third world countries and coming to these richer countries, and it's making the richer countries richer, and it's making those third world countries even poorer because all the business owners, all the people with skills are leaving. And what I think could happen is they keep punishing those trying to build wealth in the West, they keep making it more burdensome, and they keep punishing those that are trying to build wealth. Really, for example, they just give all these people money that are doing nothing, it's going to create a society that's lazy, that's not entrepreneurial, and then that means there'll be another productive part of society that have to pay for all those lazy people. But then if all the productive people leave, there's no one to pay for the welfare anymore. So this is why it's a very fine balancing act. And while I do think personally the poor do need help, they also can't go too hard on the rich. And now I'm not rich, so I'm not being biased here. This is me studying history and the facts. They have to have a balance. And really what they have to do for those people in the lower class is they have to help them create skills and create an economy which gives you opportunities and motivates and inspires people to use their creativity and use their passions to create businesses. Because really it's creating businesses and using capital to invest that creates wealth. And it's not just putting all your money in Dogecoin or putting all your money in Bitcoin and YOLOing and hoping your $1,000 goes to $100,000. Really what it is providing value to society, creating businesses and improving productivity and producing things. So everyone, that's just my two cents on these new proposal tax plans. How I think it's going to affect the housing market. Well, I don't think it's actually going to help those that it's trying to help, and why I do think it will make the housing crisis even worse. For all my loyal viewers and subscribers still watching, you're awesome. If you haven't already, please tap that like and subscribe button. I'll keep you up to date with the latest housing market, stock market, and global finance news. If you're bored, I'll put up some of my other videos here. I'll see you there.